What is going on, everybody? It is your boy Relatable Panda, and we are here to talk about the latest episode of She-Hulk, more specifically some theories as to what we just saw. Want to preface this by saying it's a huge spoiler warning. If you haven't seen the episode or don't really care to see She-Hulk, don't care about spoilers, you can continue. If you are like me and want to avoid spoilers at all cost, do not move forward in this video. I will give you all about 2 seconds. One, two. All right. For those of y'all that did stay for the spoiler warning, I told y'all so. I want to start that off right real quick. Back when we did the WandaVision stuff, I told y'all Mephisto was going to be in the MCU. Y'all laughed at me. Here we are today. He is now in the MCU. And let's talk about how we know that. So, the character who divulges the information of Mephisto being in the MCU goes by the name of Madison. Ditzy, drunk all the time, love the character so far. Anyway, she's a part of a magic act that sees her get transported through Sling Portal to a different realm. That realm looks a little bit more of the, like, villagey pilgrimage, not pilgrimage, but more villagey type, medieval type realm. We later find out that she describes this realm as a fire realm. She's in like a fire type realm. She was trapped in a lava pit, to which a talking goat helped her out of the lava pit in exchange for 6 drops of her blood. Kind of a weird thing for a talking goat to do. More weird thing about that is the goat's name is Jake. For all my comic fans out there, we know Mephisto is his human alias is Jack, so it's really easy for those two to be mistaken, as well as it is also very likely that she was talking to Mephisto himself, but she was drunk, so she thinks it's a goat, which is very likely because, you know, the cape that he wears has a little popped up collar that kind of goes over his head to resemble horns, and goat resembles the devil in basically every variation that you know of. We also do know that the reason for that is because she doesn't really state the specific name or the details of the pact that she made, because the goat threatened to reap her soul and the souls of all that she loves, which is basically what Mephisto wants to do with the humans. Not to mention later on in the episode, we see She-Hulk and Wong fighting demons and goblins that are coming from this broken Sling Portal that resembles the same fire realm that Madison was, that she described. I've been saying this since WandaVision. Mephisto will be a big bad in the MCU, and now we have even more proof that he is in the MCU. I'm at a loss for words, honestly, because I would love for that to be the case. It all makes sense. It's all adding up. A fire realm that's similar to hell. A talking goat by the name of Jake that helped her out of a lava pit that she was in and made a pact with her in exchange for 6 drops of her blood. Kind of weird that it's that specific, that it's 6 drops. Basically, the reason that the goblins and the demons tie into this, for all my comic book lovers out there, Lilith, who is also kind of like the right hand to Mephisto, can conjure and summon goblins, demons, and literal hellspawns whenever she wants to attack at any point in time. And a broken Sling Portal would be the best way to unleash those into the human world to make his presence known. But that is the latest theory and evidence that we have that Mephisto is in the MCU. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Like this video, subscribe, all that fun stuff. Let me know, do y'all think I'm going crazy with this? Do y'all think I'm looking too far into it? Or are you on the same boat as me and we are just gonna ride this Mephisto train till the wheels fall off? Let me know what y'all think, guys. Again, this has been Relatable Panda, coming at you with more Mephisto theories, as well as MCU talk. Let me know if y'all want more. I love y'all. See y'all later.